While Russian President Vladimir Putin has been criticized by many Western powers, how is his Syria campaign being seen at home? Well, earlier I spoke with Ian Bremmer, president of the Eurasia Group, and I began by asking him about a new poll from the Levada Center showing that Russian public opinion over Syria has changed dramatically.
It is a big turnaround. I guess what I can say is that earlier polls were taken before there was any military activity, before there was a drumbeat. Now, of course, 90% of Russians get their news from television, their primary news, and that is really controlled by the Russian government. So there's a steady drumbeat of patriotism. It is absolutely showing that the Russians are, you know, sort of trying to take lead where the Americans have screwed up. And so as a consequence, there's a sense that the Russians are important now and they're making a difference. And of course, they haven't taken any casualties yet either. So if you put all of those things together, you know, the initial euphoria and the fact that we don't have any of the big long-term problems coming to roost, you would expect that the height of popularity would be at the beginning of such an episode.
Okay, it's a good point about, you know, this being at the height of euphoria right now, Ian. But the Russian public isn't exactly happy with where the economy is right now and how Putin has been handling it.
The Russian people are happy with Putin. That's very different from where the Russian economy is. He, of course, has blamed the U.S.-led sanctions for the economic hit to a degree. And anti-Americanism in Russia is extraordinarily wide and deep at this point. To be fair, the Russian economy has also been terribly mismanaged under Putin's leadership, and we have certainly seen that. It's a kleptocracy. We've not seen diversification of the economy away from oil, gas, and military. So that means that even when oil prices were relatively high, the Russian economy was trending towards flat growth. Now that you have oil prices in the 40s, you're expecting a contraction of some 4%. Now, look, Putin expects to run this country until 2024 at a minimum, and there's no question he can't continue to run the Russian economy into the ground without taking significant hit to his popularity over the long term. But, you know, these are early days, and, you know, if you ask me right now, is the average Russian prepared to suck up, you know, a few months, a year of economic challenges and still support the Kremlin? The answer is very clearly yes. It's not as if there's significant opposition figures in Russia right now that are really toting a different line.
And in these early days, though, Ian, I mean, what we're seeing right now, at least the optics of it, is that Russia is becoming the dominant player, really, in Syria. And we're seeing Russia, once again, outmaneuvering the West, the U.S. First, it was in Ukraine, and now we're seeing this in Syria. So obviously, this is going to boost Putin's popularity.
Well, I don't know if they're outmaneuvering the West. I think what's clear is that the Americans have consistently not been willing to actually engage in Syria. The U.S. doesn't believe that they have people on the ground that they can support effectively. They're not prepared to put military boots in themselves. So, I mean, you've got a vacuum for 4 years. If anything, it's surprising that it's taken Putin this long to really shore up his one significant military ally in the region, Bashar Assad.
Isn't this a pretty large gamble for Putin? I mean, this intervention, could it backfire on Putin, especially, you know, when you have Russia, you know, already fighting an Islamist insurgency in the south? I mean, could this backfire and make Russia more of a target against terror attacks?
Well, we've already seen some senior Saudi clerics that have declared jihad against both the Russians and the Iranians in Syria. There are over 3,000 Russian citizens that are presently fighting for ISIS, both in Iraq and Syria. Those numbers dwarf American citizens. There will be vulnerability to terrorist attacks. But, you know, Putin has played this game before. His popularity shot up after an apartment building in Moscow was destroyed. The Kremlin claims because of Chechen terrorism. There's always been questions about that. Russian popular opinion absolutely can be manipulated in the near to medium term on these issues. The question is, what's the long-term cost for the Russian economy, and what else will Putin ultimately have to do to maintain that position?